We are going to talk about waste management during the coronavirus pandemic. As the coronavirus crisis continues to spread, ISVA considers waste management during this crisis as a key element that contributes to overall public health protection. For that reason, we will develop and circulate several videos and resources that will make sure that all our members and the hundreds of thousands of professionals that follow ISVA will have a state-of-the-art information about waste management operations during the COVID-19 pandemics. This is the first video and deals with waste workers, the most valuable part for delivering waste management services without any interruption. The video describes the health and safety measures that waste workers should apply without any exception. These measures are always important, but they are becoming vital this period. The second video will describe what the citizens should do to protect waste workers and minimize the possibilities to spread the virus and infections. So let's see how we will protect waste workers maintaining regular waste collection uninterrupted. Regular waste collection services are a key element for the quality of our lives. Usually we understand how important they are only when we miss them. During this crisis, our first target should be to ensure that waste collection will be continuously delivered all around our cities, without any disruption and without any discrimination based on income, religion, race, or nationality. To achieve that, waste collection workers should be protected as they are one of the most vulnerable parts of our societies, since they are already exposed in many health risks. Waste collection workers is the second most important human shield to coronavirus after the health workers. This is why waste workers have been granted the status of key worker by the UK government, meaning that they will continue to receive a lot of extra benefits during the coronavirus crisis, so they will be able to continue their essential services. ISVA suggests all the governments should follow this example. So our first priority is to increase their protection. This means that besides the measures that are taken for the whole population, we have to take care for extra measures like the following. First, careful and continuous use of the relevant health and safety equipment. An important measure here is to make sure that the workers are removing masks and gloves without getting in contact with them, which means usually with the help of someone else. Protective equipment for eyes should also very seriously be considered in this case. Direct contact without gloves with bins and bags should be definitely forbidden and avoided in any case. Uniforms should be daily changed and cleaned. And we should avoid shaking clothes and shoes in front of our colleagues. Wash your clothes at a temperature of at least 60 degrees of Celsius with common detergents and add disinfectants if possible. A disposable set of gloves should be used daily, so you avoid direct contact of your skin with your gloves. And make sure that disinfectants are available in each and every vehicle. Frequent hand washing and intensive cleaning of workers' facilities is also required. Drivers should avoid contacts with collectors and residents. And after each shift, the driver's cab should be cleaned and disinfected, paying particular attention to the fabrics, which represent a site of greater persistence of the coronavirus comparing to the steering wheel and the gearbox, which can be more easily sanitized. If you use vacuum cleaner, do it after disinfection. Of course, social distancing practices should be applied at the headquarters, at meeting rooms, and importantly, at changing rooms as well. The second priority for any system is to develop contingency plans that will make sure that waste collection should be uninterrupted, just to make sure that no extra health risks are added on top of the pandemics. Contingency plans should involve alternative solutions for personnel, vehicles, infectious waste, accumulation of waste, washing, disinfection, and street cleaning services. Almost all around the EU, municipalities and regional authorities are already developing similar plans. We strongly suggest each and every municipality in the world to develop such a plan. As you already said, besides what the workers will do to protect themselves, citizens have to contribute to the waste workers' protection as well. But this will be the subject of our second video.